Human beings, all 8.2 billion of us, you and I, are at a crossroads in our history right now. A point we have never been at before in the known existence of our species. And there is a rapidly growing consensus among leading experts that we are on the brink of a transformation that has the potential to completely disrupt our way of life as we know it, for better or for worse. And more than ever, we need people to be aware and paying attention. My name is Sam Bischof. I am an entrepreneur, filmmaker, and photographer, but above all else, I am just another human who spent countless hours poring over these topics. And when I realized that awareness and understanding were severely lacking, I created this. So, if you are also a human and your brain hasn't already been rewired for constant distraction, I invite you to stay until the end. The crossroads humanity stands at today is marked by the rapid convergence of multiple technologies, with one technology in particular that will soon prove to be the catalyst for the most transformative events in human history. This convergence isn't just about the individual advancements of these technologies, but how they interact and amplify each other's capabilities, and what that will inevitably mean for our very near future. This catalyst technology is, of course, artificial intelligence. And regardless of your opinion of the current state of AI, or how tired you are of even hearing those words, what we see of AI today is the upcoming and inevitable intersection where AI capabilities will soon explode. This will make the current models look primitive in comparison and accelerate nearly every other field of study at a pace humans have never experienced, creating an impending collision of technologies that will catapult us into a future the majority of us are not prepared for. AI has quickly become the fuel that has turned the steady flame of our species' technological advancements into a wildfire. And while I believe that there is a long list of things to be optimistic and excited about regarding AI's future, there are also major concerns. And we humans are racing down this path, and I believe that it's in the best interest of any logical, semi-intelligent being to understand the nature of these advancements, who controls them, and their implications. But before we dive in, you should know that while I am sharing these concerns in my own words and in my own creative way, these concerns have been and continue to be recognized and articulated by many others, a shared understanding communicated by numerous voices, including leading scientists and researchers across various fields and backgrounds. On August 15th, 2024, a paper was published by the former CEO of Stability AI and the founder of Schelling, also an AI company. He published this paper as a call to action, informing the public of the drastic change AI will soon bring to all of our lives. Let me start by reading what he wrote in the introductory paragraph of that paper. He said, "As things stand, a handful of people will determine the future of AI. They have the potential to control every part of our lives. Annual global AI investment will approach $200 billion by 2025, yet the drastic change we shall soon encounter is understood by few. A new form of intelligence is being created that will transform our collective human existence." Artificial intelligence is a field of computer science purpose-built to eliminate the need for as much human input as possible through automation. Today's AI models are composed of intelligent computer systems trained on trillions of data points, capable of processing that data in a fraction of the time it would take us humans. And with that data, AI systems can quickly identify patterns, make decisions, and even adapt and improve their own performance over time. At a high level, AI is about creating machines that can think and learn in ways that mimic human cognitive processes, executing complex tasks from simple instructions or prompts. The versatility of machines designed to mimic human intelligence can be applied across every industry, And it's reported that more than 50% of businesses in the US alone have already started using AI in some fashion. But if you recall what was said earlier, that today's models will soon look primitive, this raises our first of many concerns, which is the displacement of millions of jobs around the world, as corporations will undoubtedly opt for lower cost labor performed by computers and robotics in the name of higher profit margins. But if you don't believe me, you can take a look at the Global Economics Analyst report that Goldman Sachs published, and it estimates that AI could automate 1/4 of the global workforce. That's 300 million full-time jobs around the world. Of course, it's worth mentioning that historically, breakthrough technologies have often led to the creation of new jobs. However, the very purpose of AI is to remove the need for human input. And while the AI boom is estimated to create some 97 million jobs by 2025, it will not create more jobs than it will displace. Remember, the very purpose of AI is to reduce the need for continued human input and supervision. We have just barely scratched the surface of what this technology is truly capable of. And the more you learn, the more you understand how it truly will change everything. Artificial intelligence is progressing at an alarming rate in its ability to mimic human cognitive functions. We're approaching a critical juncture where the distinction between simulation and replication becomes increasingly blurry. The question is no longer whether it will change the world. The question is whether we are prepared for the world it will create. In the short term, those who embrace AI and learn to use it will not only increase their efficiency and productivity many times over, but they will also become much more valuable to corporations and organizations that are all scrambling to adopt and integrate AI into their models. I have personally witnessed how AI has transformed the way I approach my work, allowing me to now accomplish tasks in minutes that once took hours or even days. This isn't just a possibility, it's literally happening now, and those who fail to adapt will be left behind. Current AI models have already increased efficiency and productivity for millions and millions of people. Skills like coding, research, data analysis, design, copywriting, photography, and video production that once took humans thousands of hours to learn and master can now be produced in minutes by someone with no experience in those fields, at a level indistinguishable from that created by a skilled human. These tools will empower us beyond what humans have ever been capable of. In fact, the CEO of the most prominent and influential AI technology company in the world, along with his other tech friends, have a running bet on what year the first billion-dollar company will be created by a single individual leveraging the power of AI. While these advancements are already proving to be transformative in incredible ways, there is a much darker flip side to that same coin. And it's on this side of the coin that the majority of concerns originate. This massive increase in efficiency, productivity, and innovation wasn't just designed for use at an individual level. In fact, it has only just begun to trickle down to the individual level for consumer use. This technology is being developed and leveraged by the largest organizations, corporations, and government bodies in the world, granting them more power than they have ever had before, regardless of their moral and political alignments. There is a current race among these entities to be the first to wrap their meaty little paws around the holy grail that is artificial general intelligence, the approaching point where AI systems are capable of adapting and learning much in the same way humans do across all intellectual domains. This will effectively create a versatile, learning-capable entity that could assist and even lead in complex problem-solving tasks at blinding speeds every second of every single day, multiplied by billions. Artificial intelligence grants these organizations an immense amount of power and control. These same organizations, which have routinely demonstrated a preference for profit over people, are the ones that stand to gain the most from the continued development of this technology. And I know that I am not the only one who looks around right now and observes the state of things and wonders, what in the actual hell is going on? I know that I am not the only one who, over the last 5 years, has almost completely lost trust in organizations, institutions, and publications telling me what's right and what's wrong, what's healthy and what's not, what's true and what isn't. The majority of human beings are sleepwalking into a future we are not prepared for. Meanwhile, the corporations and institutions that quite literally run the world are charging full steam ahead, with dollar signs in their eyes showing little to no concern for anything other than the profit and power AGI promises to bring. The rampant greed that exists among the most powerful organizations and corporations, paired with the rapid development of AI, has the potential to be extremely disruptive in very uncomfortable ways for our communities and societies. We, the everyday humans, are the ones that will have to live through the decisions currently being made at the top regarding AI development and its ethical use. The question is whether or not we trust that those same establishments driving AI innovation truly have our best interest in mind throughout the process. It's concerning to me that in a recent worldwide study conducted on the ethical use of AI, principles like truthfulness, intellectual property rights, and children's rights were mentioned in less than 10% of the guidelines. It's also concerning to me that OpenAI, the company that created ChatGPT, once started as a humble nonprofit organization way back in 2015, with the noble mission of democratizing AI for the benefit of all mankind. However, it has since morphed into a multi-billion dollar private company with a for-profit model, quickly becoming one of the fastest growing companies in history and the most prominent and influential AI technology company in the world, currently valued somewhere north of $80 billion. It's also concerning to me that last year, this same company experienced an implosion within its board of directors and executives. This not only resulted in the founder and CEO himself being temporarily ousted, but also led to several notable figures stepping down from the company, including the head of OpenAI's alignment team, who was tasked with overseeing the ethical alignment of AI for the company. He cited disagreements with OpenAI's leadership about the company's core priorities, eventually reaching a breaking point. He expressed concern that not enough bandwidth was being spent on the safety and ethics of AI development. It's also concerning that following this recent implosion, several new members have since joined the board of OpenAI. And for the life of me, I just can't figure out why they would pick some of these individuals. Paul M. Nakasone, for example, the former director of the NSA and commander of the United States Cyber Command, who recently announced his retirement, but quickly snagged a seat on the board of OpenAI just a few months after. Keep in mind that the NSA is the same agency that ran a mass surveillance program that illegally collected data on millions of unknowing citizens before AI. If you're not familiar with that, look up the Patriot Act and the USA Freedom Act and have a read. You can say what you want about Paul, but the NSA certainly has an interesting track record, don't they? But let's see, who else joined the board? We have, Larry Summers. Interesting. If you need a quick refresher, Larry Summers has served in some of the most powerful financial positions in the world, such as United States Secretary of the Treasury, Director of the National Economic Council, and Chief Economist of the World Bank, just to name a few. Larry, along with many other things, is also widely criticized for having played a major role in the 2008 economic collapse. I would highly encourage you to have a quick scroll through his very public Wikipedia page. But what I find even stranger is that way down here towards the bottom of the page, there's a paragraph about his quote, special connection with none other than Jeffrey Epstein, which dates all the way back to the 90s. A small amount of digging reveals quite a few interesting things about their long-term relationship. For instance, while Larry Summers was president of Harvard University, he gave Epstein his own private office after he pledged millions of dollars to the institution, despite having no formal connection with Harvard. and according to flight records introduced as evidence in the 2021 trial of Epstein, Summers flew on Epstein's private plane on at least four occasions, which included at least one visit to Epstein's famous little island. Even after Jeffrey Epstein's guilty plea and conviction, Larry and Epstein went on to meet over a dozen times between the years of 2013 to 2016 alone. So let me ask you this. In light of the lack of regulations mentioned earlier regarding the rights of our children, does a specially connected, well-known long-term associate of one of the worst abusers of children's rights seem like a good fit for the board of the most influential AI technology company in the world? My answer would be a resounding no. So, what do we do? These are big problems we are discussing, and in many ways they can seem completely insurmountable to us everyday folk, too complex to understand or too far out of reach for one individual to make any meaningful impact on the outcome of it all. But I think we humans sometimes incorrectly assume that because a problem is complex, that the solution must also be complex. When in reality, the key to navigating these unprecedented times of technological advancement may be surprisingly straightforward. It doesn't require a degree in computer science or a deep technological understanding of AI. Instead, the most powerful tool at our disposal is something far more accessible, and the solution lies in fostering informed communities. The invention of the printing press democratized information for the general public, allowing for the publishing of new ideas and philosophies that informed public opinion and ultimately challenged the absolute power of the monarchs and aristocrats of that time. Informed communities have always been the catalyst for change when the balance of power shifts too far in one direction, or when our safety, well-being, and livelihoods are at risk. We are fortunate to be living in a day and age where there has never been a better time in the known history of our human species for everyone everywhere to easily connect, share resources and information, and thoughtfully analyze the status quo with accurate data and facts. We as everyday humans wildly underestimate the power we actually have as a digitally connected species 8.2 billion strong to create awareness and community that can drive change and steer the outcome of these developments in our favor. So why am I doing this? Why does all of this matter to me, and why should it matter to you? Well, because I care deeply about the truth, the kind of truth that can only be found by sifting through mountains of data, asking the right questions, suspending our biases and opinions, and taking a logical look at the answers that we find. I have spent thousands of hours researching, studying, and understanding the intricate web of AI, corporate influence, and the future that we are hurtling towards. But more than just the intellectual pursuit, it's about ensuring that the world we're building is one where people like you and me aren't left behind or manipulated by those who hold the reins of these extremely powerful technologies. I am not content to sit idly by while the future is shaped without our input. I believe we as individuals and as a collective have the right to be informed, to ask questions, and to demand transparency. So, along with the continued content I will be creating, I will also soon be announcing the launch of The Anti-Company. And as the name implies, The Anti-Company is centered on a core ethos of complete transparency, with an innovative revenue model designed to always leave a net positive benefit on society by prioritizing people over profit. TAC is an AI-powered community platform designed to foster a strong sense of community and connection. It's built to spread awareness, and it's a space where members can come together around our shared concerns, offering incredible tools to make networking, collaboration, and most importantly, education easier than ever. As a member of TAC, you'll have access to expert resources, courses, and guides, and a network of like-minded individuals, all designed to facilitate real connections and support, allowing us to grow both personally and professionally while contributing to this larger mission. TAC will also have a strong income earning opportunity for its members as we begin to see more and more job losses in the coming years. TAC was built as a direct response to the greed and exploitation that have become synonymous with many modern day corporations. TAC is aiming instead to foster total trust, community, and genuine value for every single member involved and for our communities beyond. All of this content I continue to produce, from in-depth videos to podcasts, newsletters, and blogs, will be freely available on all major platforms. This content is my way of ensuring that everyone has access to the knowledge they will need to understand and navigate the changes we are facing. Now, here is what I'd like to ask you to do next. If anything I've said today resonates with you, or you've felt a twinge of concern or curiosity about the direction we're headed, then please share this and leave me your email address. That's it. By doing so, you're not just signing up for another newsletter or list, you're joining a community and a movement that seeks to shift the balance of power back into the hands of the people through education and reliable information. You'll also be the first to receive updates, insights, and actionable steps that will help you stay informed and engaged as we navigate this uncharted territory together. And lastly, you'll be the first to know about the official launch of the Anti-Company. I'm not quite ready to share all of the details just yet, but I will say that getting in now will mean you'll be ahead of the curve, both in terms of knowledge and the value that you receive. This is more than just a chance to stay informed. It's an invitation to be a part of something meaningful from the very beginning. So please take that first step, leave me your email address, and I will make sure to keep you in the loop. What feels best to me about this entire project is that I can confidently and honestly tell you that the number one reason I have created and shared all of this is that I genuinely believe that our species is approaching an unprecedented era in our existence. An era we should all clearly understand and be openly discussing. We are witnessing the convergence of biological and digital revolutions. This confluence marks a pivotal moment in human history, where the decisions we and the powers that be make will have lasting effects on future generations. These parallel advances promise to reshape our socioeconomic structures, increase the likelihood of geopolitical conflict, redefine our own biology, challenge our belief systems, and even our concept of mortality. It still sounds insane for me to say that out loud, as I am sure it sounds insane to you to hear it. But the reality is that these technologies have the potential to alter the very definition of what it means to live and be human. The magnitude of this transformation far surpasses any previous leap in human progress, and I believe it requires our attention and thoughtful consideration. Remember, we as everyday humans wildly underestimate the power we actually have as a digitally connected species of 8.2 billion strong to create community and awareness that can affect real change and steer the outcome of these developments in our favor. Thanks for watching.